quite honestly, I need a vacation. So thanks to modern air travel, I can get my tickets and be at my dream destination with only a matter of hours. But before I can make like Zac Brown and get my toes in the water, ass in the sand, I'll have to get my toes out of my shoes onto the cold hard floor while I get my ass scanned by the TSA. Now, the TSA stands for Transportation Security Administration, and through my thorough research, as well as an experience as an American traveler, I've been able to determine just how much they violate our rights. This is so crucial that we understand and fight for today, as soldiers fighting overseas have died for our right to privacy and right to have no unruly insurgency or perpetrated against us by our own government. So today we're going to cover how exactly does the TSA violate your rights, what's a real solution to the TSA, and when we abolish the TSA, we can sit back, relax, and enjoy more money, more privacy, and a much enjoyable air travel experience. Now obviously, it doesn't take rubber gloves or a body scanner for that matter to see how exactly the TSA does violate our rights, but on the topic of body scanners, Victoria Sutton, writing for the 2019 Health Matrix Journal, has discovered that these body scanners are essentially a digital strip search. They reveal everything on your clothing. Yes, everything. That tattoo you got last spring break with your friends, or a surgical augmentation even. This is all open for anyone to see without even getting a warrant. And on the topic of searching without warrants, the TSA, according to the ACLU, actually has a common practice of going through electronic devices. And Sam Levin, reporting for The Guardian while interviewing ACLU officials, was actually able to determine that this is occurring more and more often. And according to legal scholars, Alexander Carpenter, writing with the 2019 North Dakota Law Review, was able to determine that this is in fact a Fourth Amendment violation as ruled by the Supreme Court. And to add to that, Stephen Ochia, a lawyer writing for the Fordham Urban Law Journal, was able to determine that when the police investigate you for something that's electronic related, they need a warrant for an individual piece of data that they want to try to pull. So we're essentially saying that the TSA, the pretender police, who are just security, have more legal authority than the actual police, who have gone through extensive training on how to do their jobs and keep us safe. Now, not only is it dangerous that the TSA takes our data, it's dangerous that we don't have any control of where it's saved, how long it's there, and who exactly sees it. And according to Dr. Mattis Hamburg, a data scientist writing for the Association of Computing Machinery in 2019, determined that this is really dangerous, that we have people who have just virtually extended access to our data, can take it anywhere. And according to another article written by the Association for Computing Machinery in 2019, the TSA also has a theft culture. Now, not only does the TSA violate you bodily, electronically, they'll steal your luggage. How awful is that, that the government, the people we trust to protect our property, will end up stealing it? And to go off of that, when doing an investigation with the Federal Reserve Bank of St. Louis, Jeffrey Cohen, in 2002, right after the TSA was created, determined that you're more likely, as a traveler, to have your property stolen by a government official than an actual airport employee or another passenger. This is outrageous that you have to risk getting your stuff stolen just by traveling to have it checked for your safety, which we'll get to more later. Now, not also does the TSA steal your stuff? Do they violate you? They'll discriminate against you. And if there's one thing I learned in my comp class with Mickey Plummer, it's that you shouldn't be a jerk. Discriminating is what jerks do. So, lawyer William Russell, writing with the National Academy of Medicine and Engineering, actually determined that the TSA is holding hearings with Congress right now because of increasing reports on discrimination. And lawyer Hugh Handyside, researching for the American Civil Liberties Union, determined that the TSA profiles so much because they have human biases incorporated into their search algorithms. And what happens when we import human bias into government search algorithms? Certainly not racial profiling, because we all know the government of America has never had a history of racially profiling. Now, we obviously know that that's true. So the TSA will racially profile in their algorithms to try to stop terrorists. But who are these so-called potential terrorists? People from the Middle East, people from South America, people of ethnic minorities are being profiled against. And this is outrageous that we have to deal with this when our Constitution says that we should never have the right to be perpetrated against based on the color of our skin or how we look. But it gets even worse. When traveling with my mom on a family vacation, we were stopped and questioned very invasively, and we have been had to go to a back room because of recent trauma surgery my mom underwent due to a knee injury. This is outrageous. No one has the right to feel like they're dangerous, they're less than, because of the way they look or a life-changing medical procedure. And to top it all off, Bruce Schneider, a security analyst working with Harvard, was able to determine that the TSA has a successful 95% failure rate when investigated by the Department of Homeland Security to actually find mock weapons and explosives being snuck on the plane by terrorists. This is ridiculous. They're supposed to be protecting us. But in reality, Schneider's research determined that the TSA actually performs security theater. They do so many extensive security checks to make us feel safe, but don't actually get the job done. But never fear, there's hope. The real police, John McClane and Die Hard 2, are here to save the day. So we're going to talk about now what the solution is, which is the real police. In fact, Francis Spokane and Professor Sinden from Temple University wrote a research article that determined that modern security innovations really keep us safe. What is this? It's the real police. Sky marshals, specially trained agents that fight and die for us in the skies to protect us in the event of emergency, are on each international flight, and they will keep us safe. But we just don't have police in the airplanes. We also have police in the airports. Airport police are bonded police departments that go through the same training as any other local law enforcement agency, and they will keep you safe in the airports. But not only that, we have intelligence officers, the CIA and the FBI, working nationally and internationally to stop terrorists from even getting in the door. And according to analyst Bruce Schneider from Harvard, as mentioned earlier, this is what actually stops terrorism. And the private sector has a key role too. As we see airlines increase their security measures by adding blast doors to planes, arming pilots, and training flight attendants to respond to medical emergencies, the private sector is engaging in the skies. But according to Dr. Spendit's research from Temple University, they also have major grounds to grow as a replacement force for the TSA by implementing more conservative security measures to get supplemented by police enforcement. Now, I want you to take a step back and imagine walking in the terminal, waving at your favorite Delta Airlines security representative, as you don't have to worry about being profiled or wasting all your money. Now, speaking of money, abolishing the TSA will actually save us $7 billion, according to Bruce Schneider. That's money that can go back to the taxpayers to do research to prevent security threats from happening and to further fund airline security in the skies and with the police. Now, I just want to review all about what we talked about today. We have talked about how we can save our time and preserve our freedoms and rights by abolishing the TSA, that the real police are the solution, and once we abolish the TSA, modern security can phase them out and save us our time, money, and freedoms without the hassle. And I'd like to leave you with a quote from Patrick Henry. Give me liberty or give me death. Help me abolish the TSA.